Hi everyone. In today's video, we will see how a servo motor is controlled by Outseal Arduino PLC. Servo motors are used in applications that require precise control and positioning of physical movements, such as robotics projects. The SG90 servo motor contains a DC motor, gear train, potentiometer, and control PCB to ensure precise control and positioning. A pulse width modulation signal of 50 Hz or 20 milliseconds is used to control the motor. A pulse length of 1.5 milliseconds is required to keep the motor in the middle position, which is at 0 degrees. 2 milliseconds of pulse length will set the position to 90 degrees to the right, and 1 milliseconds will set it to minus 90 degrees to the left. The connection of the motor is red for 5 volts, brown for GND, and yellow for control input. The Outseal PLC Mega has two PWM outputs at 0.7 and 0.8, and the PLC Nano has just one PWM output at 0.7. In today's demonstration, the servo motor control input will connect to the PLC Nano's 0.7 output, which is D9 of the Arduino Nano. Since the Outseal PLC Nano's 0.7 PWM output is inverted, this BC547 transistor circuit can be used to restore it. But I will use an Optocoupler module with a 10 kilo ohms pull-up resistor connected to pin D9 of the Arduino Nano as shown. It is recommended to power the motor with an external 5 volt power supply connected to a common ground with the Nano. The SETPWM instruction in Outseal Studio sets the channel, frequency and duty cycle of the PWM output of Outseal PLCs. For the PLC Nano, only channel 1 is available. The servo motor operates with a frequency of 50 Hz. Since the duty cycle in Outseal PLC is from 0 to 1000 points per thousand instead of percentage, the servo motor duty cycle should then be calculated. The required pulse length to position the motor from minus 90 degrees to 90 degrees is from 1 to 2 milliseconds of its total 20 milliseconds. The PPT for 1 millisecond at minus 90 degrees is equal to 50 PPT, while 2 milliseconds at 90 degrees is 100 PPT. Thus, 1.5 milliseconds at 0 degrees is 75 PPT, at least theoretically. Practically, minus 90 degrees requires 20 PPT. 90 degrees is 130, while 0 degrees remains 75 PPT. Select I.1 as the duty cycle so that we can set the values in simulation mode. Ensure that the correct port number and a baud rate of 57600 or 115200 are selected. Then upload the code into the PLC and select online mode. Input 75 and send it to I.1 in the simulation window. Observe that the servo motor is at 0 degrees. Input 130 to position it to 90 degrees and 20 to position it to minus 90 degrees. Now, let's create a program that will self-position the servo motor between minus 90 to 90 degrees. Insert 6 rooms into the program. Add a one-shot rising and a copy instruction to the first room. The copy instruction will initialize the motor to minus 90 degrees with a duty cycle of 20. Drag the timer on delay T1 to the second room, with a time delay of 500 milliseconds. Add a contact and a branch to the third room. Drag the DN status of T1 to the contact, a timer on delay T2 to the first branch, and a copy instruction to the second branch. The copy instruction will position the motor at 0 degrees with 75 PPT. Repeat the previous steps in the next rung with the T2D end status contacts, a T3 timer on delay, and a motor position of 90 degrees with 130 PPT. And on the next rung with T3D end status contacts, a T4 timer on delay, a return to the motor position of 0 degrees with 75 PPT. Drag a contact and a branch into the penultimate rung. Drag the DN status of T4 to the contact. 4 reset instructions to the first branch, and a copy instruction to the second branch. The timers will reset when T4 time elapses, and the motor position will return to minus 90 degrees to restart the process. When the code is uploaded to the PLC, observe that the position of the servo motor changes from minus 90 degrees to 90 degrees and back again. That is all for today. Thanks for watching. Please click on the like button and the subscribe button if this video is helpful to you. See you in the next video.